I would love to play Pokemon Go that everyone's been talking about lately, but I'll wait until it's officially released in the UK, even though I would mind trying it, but the problem is I can't have certain devices that have certain operating systems, so I'm kind of stuck in limbo, so to say. Even though I would mind trying and downloading it on iOS and tethering it on my Windows phone when I'm out and about, but then again, it kind of drains a lot of data, so to say, when it comes to playing and these sort of games. But oh well. So for the meantime, Red Dead Redemption is now available for backwards compatibility, and I can't wait to play it. What are you looking at? Whoa!
It's a vlog.
Yeah, I got a PlayStation belt. It's dead cool. I mentioned about some PlayStation related things in a bit. Anyways, hi, I'm Steven, welcome to CT Films. It's a vlog. So, what videos I did this past 1 week? Oh, I just did the one particular video this past 1 week. As I mentioned quite briefly on my last vlog, that I'm lacking a bit on content lately and all that, in the summer in general. But I decided to order something on Amazon, which is a particular brand that not much people know of, and wanted to do an unboxing video for you guys of a blooming selfie stick. I know it was a bit lame, and I know not much people kind of watched it, but I wanted to make a video about it anyways. Well, then I wanted to get a particular selfie stick with a tripod mount onto it, so you know, I can attach it to my trusty tripod right here. I'll show you. But you know, just attach it, and if I wanted to make some weird, you know, different types of camera angles, so to say. And plus, and since most vloggers these days and tend to you know, use their device and have it like that, and extending it, you know, like that, and vlogging like that, but people tend to do it like this also. Another reason why I kind of got a selfie stick, but I think I rarely use this though, but I kind of want to mount on my tripod so I can get a bit an extra height, because when you extend this tripod quite fully, it's not that much height than it is than the traditional tripod, so to say, is what I'm trying to say in general. Anyways, I'm rambling on too much, but yeah, that's the video that I did this past 1 week. So for this vlog, I thought I'd share something that I got this past 1 week that I got back into playing quite a bit since a certain thing, and I'll mention about it in a minute. But first, I thought I'd quickly mention before we share what I got, I wanted to quickly say that as you may not know, I recently got my job pay, and I had a big sum, and I spent most of it on Amazon, Xbox Live, and eShop, and I still had some left, and I didn't know what to, and not saying kind of spend, so to say, I would have saved it, even though there are not much particular games and all that that are coming out and whatnot for this month and next month, you see, and I can still get things I need anyways, even though that, you know, anyways, I'm rambling too much, going off topic, but you know what I mean. But, so I was going to go to Scunthorpe, because funny thing actually happened when I was at my mum's one time. My stepdad was like, oh, do you want to go somewhere? And actually sneakily looked on my device on CEX's CEX in Scunthorpe, game of words, but you know what I mean, and checked up on the website on CEX and see what's in Scunthorpe. And there was actually a couple of things I wanted in Scunthorpe. So I was like, after 1 hour sneakily on my device, like, I would like to go to Scunthorpe. But instead, then, we decided to cut the grass instead. But he needed some help anyways. As you may not know, my stepdad is lacking a bit, and he's been having issues with his knees, and he's been having an operation lately. And I've been helping him out quite a bit lately, and he does appreciate it. Even though that I'm not very good when it comes to manual labour, but I had to help, you know. At least I had to do something for one another. Anyways, but you get what I'm trying to say, and I didn't go to Scunthorpe in the end, sadly. Because I wanted to get Rock Band 4. Because, you know those guitar bundles for Rock Band 4? They cost a bundle like 100-odd quid, you see. And they were doing it for like £40 for the guitar and game in Scunthorpe, in the CX in Scunthorpe, and I could have got in there. Oh well, it doesn't matter though. So instead, though, I thought I'd get something else. And I decided to think about getting this because I've been thinking about getting this since last month and the month after, let alone thinking about getting it from my holiday pay, which I had decided to get in the end anyways. But I thought I'd decide to get this, though, because as you may not have known, I had this PSP 2000 model for many, many years. If you're a long-time subscriber and watch them very old videos on the dull webcam, you know I used to play on the good old PSP quite a bit. I think it was before I got my Xbox, but you know what I mean. But I've just been playing on this PSP 2000 model for many years. As you can see by the ring around it, it's kind of beat up a bit, and now you can't barely see it on the camera, even though I can't be able to focus it. But as you can see by the screen here, even though it's a bit smudged up, it is a bit scratched up, and I had this for quite a while, and I could do with a new one actually. So I was thinking about getting a street model, even though it doesn't have Wi-Fi, even it's not beneficial and all that, which I'll mention about stuff about that in a minute. And I've been keeping tabs on one, even though they go for quite a bit, let alone 40 to 50 odd pounds, you can look enough to find one, let alone CEX does it now and again when they have one in. But I just came across this in a pawnbroker's shop and actually ended up getting a PSP Street. And here it is. Yay. And I also got a bunch of games which I'll mention about in a minute. But yeah, just nice to get a PSP Street, which is good. And the thing is, though, I kind of got this for about £27.50. And the funny thing is, though, when I mentioned a Instagram post, and I mentioned about some details in a minute when I purchased it. But then someone said, yeah, it's kind of a bit rare, so to say. But thank you for commenting, that person that commented and said about rarity, so to say. But yeah, here it is itself. Oh, it's a nice matte finish, and it looks really, really nice in matte. And I would like to get more stuff in mats, let alone my Xbox One in general can be a bit glossy sometimes. Let alone I do have a PS4 that's a matte finish, because it's the 1 terabyte one, and even the top bit is not glossy, it's the matte finish one. And the funny thing is, though, my PS3, even though it's the old fat one, it's glossy also. But anyways, I'm going off topic, but you know what I mean. And the funny thing is, though, when I first purchased this, even though it was from a pawnbroker shop, they allowed me to test it, which is nice to them. I was like, oh, it's alright. And making sure it was kind of not modded, because I know, even though that's the battery is inbuilt into the PSP, you can still mod it regardless. But I didn't want the modded one anyways, because I was a bit unsure, so to say. But yeah, I tested it, and I was like, oh, I might as well take it and test it out myself. And when I got back, it looked really nice, and I gave it a bit of a clean and all that. And when I was dabbling it even further, I realised there was a boy racer who kind of had this, because I had pictures of cars and butts, so to say. And it had a few games on it, but it didn't appeal to me. But the thing that surprised me most, even though I was quite worried about it at first, but playing with a 8 gigabyte and stick, I know you can't see that, but 8 gigabytes, which is not bad. And it had quite a bit of music as well, but I kind of formatted it straight away just in case there were some kind of things I don't want to see, actually. You know, but other than that, though, it was a really good purchase overall. And the 8 gigabytes was quite good because I had certain things on my PlayStation Network account, and I kind of actually downloaded it on my PlayStation Network account via my PS3, because this doesn't have Wi-Fi capabilities, and it doesn't have most features, so to say, even though the most features like the store and all that are kind of discontinued anyway, so there's no point anyways. But it was nice to download certain things I have on my PlayStation account and can put onto my PSP, which is good. So yeah, I'm really pleased with that. So on top of that, I decided to get some games with it. And when, as I mentioned on my last vlog, I went to down near Cleethorpes, to the Cash Converters near Cleethorpes. And when I was down there that particular week, last week, there was this pawnbroker shop, another pawnbroker shop. You'll see what I mean in a minute. But I saw this, so I was like, oh, I don't know how to get that there, even though I would like a PSP Street. And I ended up getting a PSP Street. And then on the same day I got my PSP Street, I decided to get this, which is Star Wars Battlefront 2. And I got this for about £3. Even though they're doing it for £4 in my local CEX, but it's a platinum thing. And I don't like it when it's platinum or essentials, if you know what I mean, when they rebrand their PSP games. But yeah, it's nice to get this though, even though that's in there. I know there are some other Star Wars Battlefront games exclusively to the PSP, which I wouldn't mind getting in the future, but it's nice to get Star Wars Battlefront 2 because I've been playing Star Wars Battlefront 2 on my Xbox Original when I got my Xbox Original. And the funny of which, it was my CEX friend's copy, my friend who works in CEX, it was his copy, but he couldn't be bothered to claim it back, so it was like dibs, so to say. And I've been playing that quite a bit on the Xbox Original. I was like, oh, I might as well pick this up since I got my PSP 3. So I've been playing this quite a bit, it was quite nice. And to play this as well as the Xbox Original. And I've been playing like Tony Hawk Underground 2 on my PSP as well as on the Xbox Original, and plus Spider-Man 2, even it's different than the PSP, but I played that also on the Xbox Original. So I've been playing on my Xbox Original now and again when I'm in my bedroom when I got my PSP this week. But yeah, nice to pick that up. And I thought I'd go to my local cash converters, the other one in Grimsby, and I thought I'd walk down there again to look at some PSP games. There was not much, so to say, but I actually picked up a certain something, and there's iPet, and luckily enough it came with, sorry, that's the receipt, but came with the Mac thing, even though that it does already come with a thing pre-installed into the case anyways. But I still have my PSP camera, luckily, which... Because I remember because it requires the PSP camera. And as you know, way, way, way back, it was a long time subscriber, I used to record stuff on my PlayStation PSP and camera, let alone the PlayStation 3's PlayStation Eye and all that, let alone I record stuff on my iPod now, and usually in multiple devices that I have now. But long story short, it's just saying, it didn't start to work. I was like, oh no. Don't die on me, and it managed to work, and I ended up playing a bit of iPad to try it out and test it, see if it works. But it's nice to add to my PSP collection, and it's nice to get some a few PSP games. I don't know if I'll get some more, because I was close enough to get Daxter on the PSP, and when I looked on my local CEX's site, had one in, but the problem is it was an essential one and it was a rebranded one and I didn't wanted it, so I didn't end up getting Daxter, sorry to say. But I'm really loving the PSP, and back at it again, playing on the PSP. It was just nice to play it though, which I've been playing most of this week. But yeah, it's just nice to get though. It's a nice matte finish. I don't think it'll scratch up that much. I'll really look after this one quite well, and it's just nice to try a PSP again. And the Street model is quite good for those people that really want to try out their PSP again, and it's just nice to play it again. Some ways, what I've been up to this past 1 week, I would say some certain things, but I haven't got anything in my notes, but I'll quickly mention a couple of things, actually. I ordered some stuff on Amazon, even though I got my PSP Street model. I used the rest of the money also to buy some stuff on Amazon. I ordered two things, one of which is the PlayStation belt, which was nice to get, because I wanted a new belt for the summer, which is quite nice. I ordered another thing. I don't know if it'll come in time next week, because I would like to showcase that in my next vlog, because I picked up a certain thing, which will be quite nice, and I would like to share that with you guys. Which will be quite nice. Anyways, I'm going off over topicking. But the other thing is though, and not only that, I've been buying these this past 1 week. I've been taking some money out of my account. I recently got some new shorts and socks and all that, some essentials. And I've just been buying certain things in Tesco's, because asked my mum, because we had a little bit of a list, because I've been buying stuff in my house lately, you see. And one of the things that was on my list, I wanted like a blender or a smoothie maker, because I watched a certain YouTuber Maybe just by mention about it, you guys might know who I'm talking about. But I don't like mention about certain YouTubers, you say, who are watching all that. But if when I mention about this, you might know who it is. But this person, now and again, when he vlogs, he sometimes has smoothies, you see. And it got me inspired to want to try and maybe try out smoothies, you see. And my mum totally agrees because I need to get, you know, so to say, let alone I try to keep myself active, let alone walking in general. Pokemon Go. I wish I could do that with Pokemon Go, but like I said, I've got certain devices that I have, but I'm very limited, let alone, you see. It's a really going off topic. But you know, I just wanted to get a smoothie maker, and we got that as well as some other things in Tesco's, so I got some added extra points, which is nice. And the other thing is, though, I also got this in the post, and I got an extra 250 points, which is equivalent to £2.50, which is quite nice. So I got that as well, and I'm close to £4. I think I'm up to the £4.50 stage. But if I spend a bit more, because I'll be going frozen food shopping later on and this weekend, which will be quite nice, and we might get up to the £5 tier, and I can get £5 worth. I don't know what to spend it though, which will be a bit disappointing there, because even though that the Batman Return to Arkham has been delayed, even though I was looking forward to getting that game at the end of the month, but I might, if I don't think I'll get in time because it ends until the end of August, I could put that towards No Man's Sky, but it doesn't matter though. I might put that towards maybe September, since it ends, the statement ends until the end of August. I was really rambling too much, let alone, like, as I said, I didn't know what to talk about. But other than that, I've been really fine and dandy, just been doing this and that. I had a barbecue with my mum to celebrate my stepdad's birthday and all that. So, yeah, I've just been fine and dandy. It's just that last night in general, I was that much of in the mood. I was just the close to being in the mood because I had a boring night last night doing this and that. I would have played something, but... Well, then I was waiting for Red Dead Redemption to come out, which is out now today, which I'll have a little play after this vlog, and play that. And do whatever for this weekend so I can go food shopping on Saturday and stop that up because the freezer needs filling up and all that. Anyways, I'm really rambling too much, you can tell why. Anyways, so what videos I'll be doing next week? Since the Tumblestone will be... Free games of gold next week. I would like to do some gameplay of that. Even though there are some certain things like this Kinect game that's coming out, but it's like £15 and I didn't need to get it or not, let alone this other game called Video Ball and all that. But I might just save my money and just get the Tumblestone when it's free with games of gold. And I'll do some Xbox One gameplay for you guys, which would be quite nice. Oh, I'm quite bevin quite a bit. I had a bit of cola, so to say, because I got a bottle of cola and put that towards Cola Night tonight. Anyways, so I'm really rambling too much now. So that's my vlog for you guys. Hope you're enjoying what's the understanding. I hope you guys have a really nice weekend and what you've been doing and all that. Anyways, I'll show up now. Let you guys get on with your rest of your day. You go out in the world, play Bloomin' Pokemon Go. Even I wouldn't mind playing it, but like I said, I'm very limited though. Well, my certain devices and certain operating systems. I'll try it eventually. I might just sit at home and be like, oh, Pikachu, yay, catch, yay, did it. Not saying I'm lazy, it's just that I'm very limited, let alone my devices are in limbo when it comes to doing stuff like that, let alone I have a Windows phone. Really rambling on too much now. Anyways, I better go now. See you from Steety Films.